Happy day, students.
Last session we learned what is the, we recalled all the 8th class, 9th class, what are the quadrants, how to plot the points, we'll recall. Now we are going to see the, what is the main concept we are going to learn in the class 10th. It's a distance formula and section formula by using that two only. 7.1, 7.2, 7.3 has deleted from your portions, area of a triangle has deleted. So we'll learn about the exercise 7.1 by using the coordinate geometry, that the ordered pairs. Okay, that is a, it's very important part 2 we are going to learn in this chapter. As we know that one, minus plus quadrant 1, quadrant 2, quadrant 3, quadrant 4, last session we are. So minus 3, minus 2, it's x and y value. X is called as abscissa and y is called as a ordinate. Okay, and if you see it, quadrant 1, plus, plus, minus, minus, plus, minus. So okay, now can you able to say 1 comma 0 lies in which quadrant? 1 comma 0 is not lies in any quadrant because it point on x axis, y is 0. So points which lie on the x axis do not lie in any quadrant. This you should remember. Now we are going to learn this chapter is distance formula. That is very important. For example, through two points are there. This is a P and this is a Q. Okay, this is P and this is a Q. So I want to find out, for P is for example 1 comma 2. And Q is, what is a Q is 5, 5, 5. So now what will be the for distance between these two points? Is it easy to use by scale? We can able to find out. But sometimes the order pair is not belongs to the in the graph sheet. How we can able to find out 30 comma 20 and 40 comma 10? How to find out? This coordinate geometry is very important for learning the GPS system. So this is the basic for you learning the GPS system. So this distance, what is the distance between this P and Q? We are going to learn this one. So how we can able to find out P and Q distance, the derivation of the distance formula, I am going to explain. Please listen carefully. Let P as a x1, y1. Q as a x2, y2. And this green line shows the, what is that distance we are going to find. Out we are to find out the distance. Let we draw the this P x1 comma distance, and this from here to s2 Q is the x2 y2. So now what will be the difference between these two? What will be the difference between this this point to this point? Means this point is x1 y1, this point also x1 y1. Then difference between this will be x2 minus x1 and then y2 minus y1. That difference will be there. So okay, OR, O2, R is X1, X2, OR, O2, R, where is the O, sorry, OR, O2, R is X1 and OS is X2. Same way, if you see here, PR, PR is Y1 and SQ is the Y2. Okay, PT, how to find out PT, P2T, that one I told, no, P2T is X2 minus X1, that is X axis, abscissa. And how to find out QT means Y2 minus Y1. This is X2 minus X1 and this is Y2 minus Y1. Then what will happen? Use the Pythagoras theorem. PQ square equal to PT square plus QT square. PT is X2 minus X1 and QT is Y2 minus Y1 whole square. Then square will go, that is square root. This is the distance formula. By using Pythagoras theorem, is it easy to find out the distance formula? This is the derivation of the distance formula. So repeat with me. The distance formula is equal to root over X2 minus X1 plus Y2 minus Y1. X2 minus X1 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square. Okay, let me apply this formula in some cases. Find the distance between 1 comma minus 3 and 5 comma 7. Okay, first exercise is based on the distance formula only. So what is the x1? First learn the x1, y1, x2, y2. So x2 minus, then 5 minus 1 and then 7 minus of minus will become plus. So 7 plus 3, 10, 4 square. 16 plus 100 means 116. Is it possible to write as a 2 into 58 into 4, 29 into 4, means what is the 4 square root? 2, 2 root over units. You should write compulsory units. Distance is measured by units, so you should write compulsory units. Now distance formula from the origin. Origin means it will be as a, what is that, 0 comma 0. So what is the distance between 0 comma 0 to some x comma y? So here x1 will be x. And x2 will be x and x1 will be 0. So x minus 0, y minus 0. Then x comma x minus 0 is x square and then x minus 0 is x square y minus 0 y, y whole square is y square. So the distance between from the origin is root over x square plus y square. So this is also very important formula for 1 mark. Let me see some exercise sums in a based on the using the distance formula. Show that this is very important. Show that the given points are collinear. How to find out the collinear? What is the meaning of collinear? The points lying on the same line are called as a collinear. So let me find out A, B, C, three are there. First find out the distance between A, B, then distance between B, C, then distance between A, C. After finding all, you should substitute in the value of the sum of the distance of any two points. So, for example, 212. How to write the 212? 212, you can write it as a 212, you can write it as a 4 into 4, 2 into 106. Again 2 into 53, then 4 into root over 53. Yes, understood, root over 53. Okay, and 265, how we can able to write 5 table? 5 into 53, but it is not possible. 5 root over 53 is not possible, so it is not a perfect square number. So if you add any two sides, it should be equal to third side, but it is not possible. All our irrational numbers are different here. It is not like irrational numbers, like thirds are not there, so it is not possible. Then given numbers are not in a collinear. If you add any, if it is AB plus BC, it should be equal to AC, or AC plus BC should be equal to AC. Any two distance if you add, it should be a third distance should be equal. Then it is a collinear point. But it is not equal, then it is not a collinear point. Let me see another sum based on this one. Where we are application of distance formula, where we are using. So to check the which type of quadrilateral. So first we should know the quadrilateral properties. As we know that in parallelogram, opposite sides are equal, diagonals are not equal. So if they say to find the prove that the given order pairs or given points or parallelogram means should find out AB, BC, CD, DA and AC, BD, then the property should be satisfied, then it is a parallelogram. If suppose rhombus, all sides are equal, diagonals are not equal, it should be satisfied. So you have to find out six using six times distance formula AB, BC, CD, DA, AC and BD. The same way rectangle, opposite sides are equal but diagonals are equal. And the same way square also, all sides are equal, diagonals are equal, then it is called a square. This is very important sum. One question is there in your textbook. Let me see here. In a classroom, four friends are seated at the points A, B, C, D as shown in the following figure. So now there are Champa and Chameli. They are sitting in the walk into this one. So A, B, C, D. So it is a forms a square or not, they are asking. They are arguing. Don't you think A, B, C, D is a square? They are saying. So first find out A, B. Then find out first, what is this? 6, 1. Like that, 9, 4. Like that, you have to find a 2, 6. Like that, you have to find out all the other pairs and find AB. Then after finding the this one, AB for distance formula, BC distance formula, all sides are equal. And diagonals also you have to find out. Diagonals also equal. Then it forms a square. Then it is told by, it's Champa told it's a correct. So it is correct. Champa, what is guess is correct here. So we can, by using this way also, we can able to do the quadrilateral by distance formula. We can whether check it is a given pair of pairs or quadrilaterals or not. Thank you, students. Then I hope you all can able to complete the exercise 7.1. Thank you, students.